and welcome to One Cool Thing, PC Mag's occasional video series where we talk to you about a super cool thing that we've been testing out here in PC Labs, which really is in all of our homes because everyone is still working remotely. I'm Tom Brandt, this is Michael Muchmore, and the cool thing that we've got for you today is something that you can't, that you probably can't get yet, but that you will probably be very excited to run on your computer once you can. Yes, we're talking about a new operating system called Windows 11. Michael, what do we have to look forward to?
Okay, you can get it if you have been in the Windows Insider preview release program and running the developer builds. So if you've been in the most close to the metal channel of updates, you can get it. And you can even get it without those severe requirements that that Microsoft was, that's driving everybody crazy about. You know, TPM is not a big deal. It's on every computer in the last 7 years, basically. Unless you're like an enthusiast who turned it off or something. But the CPU requirements are a bigger deal. Like, because it only runs on like eighth generation. They say it only runs on eighth generation. But as you can see, I'm running it on a seventh generation Intel computer here. So here's the lock screen. It looks like it has the time. I know it's not very clear, I guess. And I will log in, not show you my PIN. And let's see, here is, so I'm running a couple of windows here. Let me close these. I wanted to show something I will show you later about the new windowing features, but basically, sorry, you can't see it very well, but basically here is the new start menu. And if I swipe in from the side, you can see the new news widgets panel. And if you swipe in from this side, you get the controls. But we'll show you that stuff later. I just wanted to show you that I'm actually running it myself here.
And it really, it seems like from you know, the basic things that we've seen so far that Microsoft has shown and that you just showed, is that some of those swipe actions will actually be very similar to Windows 10 in terms of, like, you know, getting those things to slide over from the side. The start menu is, you know, there's still gonna be a start menu.
You know,
but the visual look of Windows 11 is so different. Talk a little bit about that.
I think that what surprised me most when I first ran it was that it wasn't drastically different feeling. It felt more familiar than I expected it to feel. Things look different. They're designed, they're smoother sort of, you know, the rounded corners, and the placement of the taskbar icons. They're smaller, which I'm not a big fan of. I really like the current more informational taskbar. You can hover over them and see a thumbnail of what's running in that app. But having the start menu somewhat on the side of this bar is less consistent than always having it on the left side corner of the screen. Like, if you know it's always there, I found it, maybe I'll get used to it, but I think I missed the original having it right in the corner.
Yeah. I'm very curious to know what they've done, if anything, change-wise to the settings situation. I know that Windows 10 has a bit of some cumbersome, settings and things like that. Have they simplified the control panel? Have they made any changes there?
The settings panel is much nicer looking now. Design-wise, I did install one Win32 old-style app. And when I went to uninstall it, I didn't get the old control panel. So as far as I can tell, I've only played with it for maybe not even an hour yet. So as far as I can tell, the old control panel stuff is gone and it's all in the nice new design, which is a big thing for Windows. That's always been a critique of Windows.
Now, the other big thing for Windows is apps. Everyone wants to figure out how to, by everyone, I mean companies want to figure out how they can kind of merge this new world that we're living in, where we're always on our mobile devices, but yet computers are now important because we're all working from home, and you're going to be able to run phone apps on your Windows 11 computer, and maybe you're going to be able to switch things between. That's been a thing for Windows for a while. Is that getting any better with Windows 11, or right, what's coming?
Well, you know, we'll still have the your phone app, which lets you connect your smartphone, particularly on Android. It doesn't do a heck of a lot with iPhones because Apple locks that system down. But on Android, and particularly if you have a Samsung Galaxy, a recent Samsung phone, you can actually run apps off of the phone on your Windows computer screen. Now, of course, that's not every Android phone. It's only Samsung's one so far. But what's new is we will have Android apps in the App Store. The apps, the Windows App Store, they call it the Microsoft Store. I think they should call it the Windows App Store, but whatever. It will have the Amazon App Store inside of the Windows App Store, and you'll be able to get Android apps from the Amazon App Store. People aren't a big fan of this. To me, it's more a talking point. It's like, do you really want to run? I mean, there is occasionally an app where you need the mobile app, but that's sort of going away a little. But you know, Chrome OS, they run Android apps, and it's just so inconsistent, and it's not great. So.
And to me, I think I'm kind of in agreement there. I think that one of the big benefits of Windows is that there is so much touch support built into the operating system that you can almost, you know, interact with non-mobile apps with your fingers.
Close windows, maximize, and do all that stuff. One of the cool things, speaking of Windows, is this is something that I think Microsoft has always had a leg up on Apple, is just the arrangement of Windows on the screen. And Windows 11 brings these new things called layouts. And what it does is you hover over the maximize button and you get like six layouts, you know, three across, you know, two small ones on this one side, a big one on one side. And you can actually pick where in that layout you want the current app to run in, and then choose what should run in the other layouts. It's pretty nice. And those layouts are remembered. If you go to multiple desktops, that's another topic we could talk about. Multiple desktops exist in Windows 10 now, and I love it. You can have, you know, one that will have your personal stuff and one desktop for your Windows stuff, for your work stuff. And now they're going to have swipe, like four-finger swipe, where you can swipe back and forth. Mac has had this for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, to me, that's essentially in Mac OS, where we swipe with four fingers on the touchpad, you go back and forth between desktops. Great to see that come to Windows.
You know, Mac like forces you to have a full desktop when you maximize an app a lot of times, which kind of I'm not crazy about. I like having my set desktop. Here's my personal, all my personal apps, all my work apps. And one new thing for these multiple desktops is you'll be able to choose a different background wallpaper for each multiple desktop, whereas, you know, now it's all the same.
So it really sounds like there's some appealing parts to this. We're still not quite sure how that Amazon app thing will work out, but overall, it seems like definitely a giant leap forward for Windows. But the big question is, can I run Windows 11 on my computer, and when can I get it?
Well, it's not going to be available until the fall, at least. They say holiday season. I mean, there actually are a bunch more things that we could talk about, Tom, before we get into that stuff. You know, in terms of the interface, of course, we mentioned the rounded corners, the new start menu. The widgets is a big deal. You'll be able to swipe in, as I showed you, to see widgets. And those can be third party, and they can be Microsoft weather and news and stuff, or news from the Times or the Journal or anything like that. We already have that in Windows 10 with that news and info, the button that they added, which is kind of convenient. It always shows the weather on my computer. It's 87 degrees Fahrenheit now. the widgets is a big deal. And it's kind of interesting because Apple just made a big deal with widgets with iOS and iPad OS. So widgets seem to be a thing that's coming back. You remember like 10, 15 years ago, widgets were a big deal. Even Chrome had widgets that you could run off the desktop. So these are different. They're in a box, but you can actually full screen the widgets on Windows 11.
I remember widgets in, I believe it was Windows 7 that they had widgets briefly, and then they went away. So it sounds like they're coming back.
And macOS had that whole, they had an actual button on the keyboard to open the widgets with the time and weather and that stuff. And
Those are long gone.
Yeah, yeah. But maybe they'll come back now that widgets are a thing again. Let's see, it still has light and dark modes. There's new system sounds, which maybe I can play later, but I haven't heard.
Yeah, in fact, what we should do, you know, in advance of Windows 11 coming out is have a bit of a Windows concert with you know, playing the new sounds.
Yeah, I do a whole video of just the sounds.
Indeed. I mean, I would like to hear them.
So far, I haven't heard a lot of them, but for some reason this computer is really quiet. But let's just see. There are a couple of things that I'm not crazy about that of windowing things. For example, putting the cursor all the way in the lower right corner now will show the desktop and close all the windows basically if you click it. I think that's gone. A lot of these sort of arrow desktop features are gone. And one of my favorite is, and you can still do it in Windows 10, if you like shake the title bar of window, everything else but the window you're on minimizes, which I find really helpful, but I guess people don't really use it. So I think
that is very helpful if you need to take a screenshot of a window without anything in the background or things like that.
I feel like it's one of those things that's really great and useful, but nobody knows about it or uses it. So,
well, and so that's the thing. So it sounds like there's a ton of new hidden features in Windows 11. Are there going to be any situations that you think that between now and the final release, Microsoft is going to, you know, tweak them or they're going to get feedback? I mean, usually that's the way it works. What are you looking at?
Yeah, and that's the whole point of the Insider program, where you have millions of people running the new version and they provide feedback. And you know, all recent versions of Windows have benefited from this. People complain. Nobody complains about Windows or Microsoft, right?
I for one have never had any problems running Windows. No blue screens, no freezes or anything like that. So
yeah, I mean, I think it's mostly a design thing. There are, you would know more about this, there are performance improvements, supposedly, like battery. I haven't seen it on this test build yet, but apparently it's going to be more efficient. One of the efficient things is that dynamic refresh, which you probably know more about. Basically, you're
yeah. So, what is dynamic refresh? I'm curious about that.
Well, it's just, you know, most screens are 60 hertz, and now we have 120, and you're not going to be running at the top refresh rate all the time in order to save the battery. It'll tone it down to save battery life.
And that's actually something that we've seen on phones now too, where you have like, you know, new flagship smartphones that run at, you know, insane refresh rates, but they're dynamic, so they don't do that all the time. I know Microsoft has, you know, they have this extensive hardware business in addition to Windows, and they've been experimenting with that on some of the Surface laptops and tablets as well to get that refresh rate, you know, dynamic in a situation that everything looks silky smooth, but that you're not taxing the system.
Exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what they're going for. It probably uses AI from Azure. But yeah, there are a couple of gaming tweaks to a couple of new gaming performance features. There's the auto HDR, and we know HDR makes images look incredibly better and clearer and more lifelike. And there's also direct storage, which will be a way to get the game loaded onto your video RAM instantly.
So is that something that people are going to care a lot about? Or it seems like Microsoft is also pushing this cloud gaming initiative with Game Pass and things like that. Use Windows to on a gaming computer, or are you going to stream everything?
Well, I mean, both. That's one thing they announced, that the Xbox Game Pass would be available in Windows 11. So you basically, anything you could play on an Xbox, you'd be able to play on a PC. And the streaming as well.
Yeah, it seems to me that like Windows 11 is going to need to change a lot between now and when it comes out, because Microsoft has you know, already all these things on the roadmap from the Game Pass thing. And the thing that also comes to mind is whatever happened with Windows 10X, which was their their initiative to move into new form factors. Has that been incorporated? Or
that whole design of the center taskbar and the interface is basically, a lot of it comes from Windows 10X. They definitely backtrack. And you know, you ask, oh, is anything going to change between now and release? Well, look at that. Like Windows 10X, everyone thought that was a done deal, and they canceled the program. It'll be interesting to see, you know, they still are pushing on Windows on ARM, and there's, you know, a lot of developer docs about, you know, getting your ARM apps to be able to work even with things that seem like they should only be Intel.
So we're going to be testing Windows 11 out over the course of the next few months before it comes. But you can too, as Michael, as you mentioned, our viewers can join the Windows Insider program, download.
If your system has like Gen 8 Intel or I'm not sure the AMD equivalent, I think it's Zen 2. As long as you have there's a list on Microsoft's web pages about, you know, which CPUs it runs on. And of course, you need the TPM module, which every computer I've tried it on had that, but most of them weren't accepted to run Windows 11 yet. Now, if you, as I mentioned, if you are already in the program, you don't need those strict hardware requirements. But if you do have, 8th gen or later, you can just sign up for the Windows Insider program and you can install Windows 11.
So
it's beta software, so don't do it on
right. critical. Not recommended to get your critical work done or to turn in your homework, but it is cool. And go ahead.
Although I have seen very little, it's been surprisingly stable. There've been a little glitches here and there, but it's pretty stable for such an early build.
But yeah, it sounds like there's a lot of tweaks that will happen, but it's a promising start. Lots of cool new features, lots of features that might need to be tweaked. We will be testing those out in PC Labs on multiple computers with running Windows 11. And we're very excited to see the final version once it hits new computers and some old computers around about the holiday season.
One thing I should say is, though, aside from the new CPU and the TPM, the system requirements are incredibly low, like 1 gigahertz processor. It seems strange. Like, are there 8th generation 1 gigahertz processors even?
Well, so the funny thing about the processor speed now is it really doesn't matter that much, right? I mean, if you were running Windows, if you're running Windows XP or Windows 98, like 20 years ago, on a 800 megahertz processor, you know, the latest 11th generation Intel processors can, you know, start as low as 1 gigahertz. The processor speed doesn't matter as much anymore. It's more of, you know, the generation of the chip, as you mentioned, 8th gen sounds like currently is what they're thinking is the minimum. Is that right?
Yeah. And I have a whole column about how Microsoft doesn't really want you to upgrade. They want you to buy a new computer.
And I encourage everyone to read that column and all of our Windows 11 coverage, which you will find on PCMag.com. There's a ton of it, advice and first looks of the new operating system. Do check that out. And we thank you very much for watching One Cool Thing. And we will be back in the near future with yet another cool thing that we're testing out here at PCMag. Thanks very much for watching and have a great day.